स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? फाइन, ओके। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विथ पार्ट टू। ओके, इन द लास्ट क्लास आई टॉट यू मोर ऑन एमएस वर्ड, इजंट इट? बट वी डिडंट कंप्लीट इट ऑल द टॉपिक्स। आई डिवाइडेड इट इनटू पार्ट वन एंड टू। इन पार्ट वन व्हाट डिड यू लर्न? यू लर्न अबाउट फाइंड एंड रिप्लेस कमांड, isn't it? About find command and the replace command. Yes, then you learned how to use the find command and how to use the replace command in MS Word. Then you learned the spelling and grammar, isn't it? How to use the spelling and grammar command. Yes, then you learned how to correct your spelling and grammar in your MS Word document, isn't it? Then you learned how to correct spelling errors. This was all I taught in the last session. Okay, we will continue further with the next topics, that is thesaurus, changing case and word count. Okay, we will continue with these three topics in this session. Okay, so shall we continue? Okay, then let's start with thesaurus. Okay, so students, today we will learn about thesaurus. Okay, we will learn about changing case, then word count, then we will do a quick revision on both the on all the topics from beginning till what we will learn today. Okay, then I will give you some assignments also, okay, that you practice at home. Okay, I will give you some assignment, and that assignment you practice at home in your computer. You practice the practical work at home in the computer. Okay, so let's begin with thesaurus. Okay, so students, what is thesaurus? Thesaurus is a tool in MS Word which offers a list of synonyms and antonyms which can be used to replace a word with one of them. Okay, what is thesaurus? It is a tool in MS Word through which you can change your word that you have typed in your document with their synonyms and antonyms. Okay, you know what are synonyms and antonyms? Synonyms are the similar words, the word that are similar to a particular word. Okay, that are synonyms. And what are antonyms? The opposite words. Okay, if you need to change some word with the synonyms and antonyms, this thesaurus helps you to do so. Okay, it is a tool in MS Word that we find to replace some words with the synonyms and the antonyms. Okay, now the use of thesaurus improve our document. What does it does? It improves our document. Some words or some particular sentence or some lines, if you want to change, if you want to make it more meaningful and more understandable, then you can use this thesaurus. Okay, it improves our document, the quality of our document, it improves. Okay, then what are the following steps to use this thesaurus? Okay, firstly, you select the word that we want to replace with its synonyms. Okay, to use this thesaurus, first of all, what we need to do, we need to select the word that we want to replace with its synonyms. Okay, that we want to replace with its synonyms. Okay, then the second point is click the review tab and click the thesaurus in the proofing group. And where do you find this thesaurus tool? You will find this thesaurus tool in the proofing group. Okay, in the proofing group you will find in the ribbon. You don't know what is ribbon? Group of tabs and commands, isn't it? You will find this thesaurus in the proofing group. Okay, first of all, what you will do, you will select the word that you want to replace with the synonyms or antonyms, and then you will click the review tab and then click thesaurus in the proofing group. Okay, this is the first two steps how to use the thesaurus tool. Okay, let's move to the second step. Now students, the next step, after clicking on the review tab and clicking on the thesaurus in the proofing group, next step you will do is the thesaurus task will appear in the right side of the document window. It encloses a list of synonyms. After clicking on thesaurus in the proofing group, in the right side of your document, okay, in the right side of a document, the thesaurus task pane will appear in the document window. In the right side of the document window, a thesaurus task pane will appear. It encloses a list of synonyms. That means it provides you with a list of synonyms with the word that you want to replace. Okay, after clicking on the review tab and opening the thesaurus in the proofing group, okay, a thesaurus task pane will appear in the right side of the document window of your MS Word. Okay, in that thesaurus task pane, a list of synonyms will appear. That means a list of synonyms will be appeared in that task pane, okay, through which you can select your word you want to replace. Okay, and after that, to select one word of the word from the list of synonyms, we can follow the steps. How can you select one word from that list of synonyms? What are the steps you need to follow? Okay, firstly, to use one of the words, select it. Click on the drop down arrow and then click on insert or copy. Okay, what will you do? You will use one of that word. Okay, then you will select it, click it on the drop down arrow. Okay, a drop down menu will appear. You click on it and then you click on insert or copy. Okay, you will click on insert or copy to replace that word. Okay, after that, to look for other related words, if you want to find some other related words, click on a word in the three list of result. Okay, you click on the related list of result. Okay, there will occur three list. Okay, then you can click on that list and then some more synonyms will be shown. Okay, some more synonyms will be shown. To look for other related words, click on a word in the three list of result. Okay, three kind of list will appear and then you click on it. Okay, more synonyms will occur, and from there you can select your required synonyms or word that you want to replace in your document. Okay, so these are the steps that you will use to use the thesaurus tool. Okay, I will show you practically how will you select it. Okay, so students, where will you find this thesaurus tool? Can you see my mouse pointer here? Yes, you will move in this review. You will move in this review tab. Okay, after that, you will click on the thesaurus. Can you see in the proofing group? This is the proofing group. Okay, you will click on thesaurus. Then in the right side, isn't it? In the right side of the document, you see the thesaurus task pane has appeared. Can you see? It encloses is a list of synonyms. Here you can type any kind of your word that you want to search. Okay, suppose I am typing something, then a list of word it is there. Can you see a list of synonyms appears? Can you see a list of synonyms has appeared? Okay, then from here you can choose any of the word that you want to replace in your document. Since I have not typed any kind of document, so that is why I am not choosing. But if you want to choose any kind of synonyms, you will do in this way. Okay, first you'll go in the review tab, then after that you will select the thesaurus. Okay, then after that a task pane will appear in the right side. The thesaurus task pane will appear. Okay, then you can select any kind of word you want to, suppose a little or something like that. Then you can use it here. Okay, you can use it in your document. Okay, and if you want to use only one word, you will select it and then you will click on insert or copy. Okay, and if you look for other related words, click on the word in the three list of result. More synonyms will appear here. You can click here. More synonyms will appear. Okay, if you want to find more words and more synonyms or antonyms, you click here. All the synonyms and antonyms will appear. Okay. So now students, let us move to the next content, that is changing case. Okay, what do you mean by changing case? Changing case means changing the size of the letters, that means from capital to small letters or from small letters to capital letter. Okay, here it is written, when we want to change the text case, that is uppercase or lowercase, we can use the change case command on the ribbon rather than deleting and retyping the text again and again. Okay, if we want to change the case of a letter, okay, if we want to change the case of a letter to uppercase or lowercase, we can change it by the use of change case command on the ribbon. Okay, rather than deleting and retyping the text again and again. Rather than deleting, that means deleting again and again or retyping again and again the same letters, we can use this change case command to change any kind of text from upper to lower case or from lower to upper case. Okay, now students, there are 5 options to change the case of the text in MS Word. Okay, how many options are there? There are 5 options to change the case of text in MS Word. Okay, first, the first case is sentence case. The first one is sentence case. This option capitalizes the first letter in a sentence. By using this sentence case, you can change the letter of the, you can change the first letter of the sentence into capital letter. Okay, as it is written sentence case, it will be changed in that way only. Okay, this option capitalize the first letter in a sentence. This sentence case capitalize the first letter in a sentence. Okay, now students, the second one is lowercase. This option changes the case of the entire text to lowercase, that means small letters. Okay, this lowercase option changes the case of the entire sentence, that means entire text, to lowercase. All the text that you have written, if you use this lowercase option, all the letters will be changed into small letters. Okay, and now comes the uppercase. version changes the case of the entire text to uppercase, that means capital letters. The text that you have written in your document, if you use this uppercase option, then the entire text in your document will be changed into capital letters. Okay, and this uppercase can also be used by the use of caps lock key, or you can press shift key and then you can start typing. Okay, all the letters in your text will be changed into capital letters. Okay, and then there is capitalize each word. This option capitalizes the first letter of each word in the sentence. By using this option, capitalize each word, okay, all the words in your document that you have written, the first letter of all the words will be changed into capital letter and the rest will remain small letters. Okay, as it is written there, capitalize each word, the first letter of each word, it is written in which letter? In capital letter. In the same manner, in your document, the text will be changed, all the letters of the first word of the word will be changed into capital letter and the rest will remain in small letters. Okay, and then the fifth one is toggle case, that is toggle case. This option switches the case of the text. Uppercase characters becomes lowercase and lowercase characters become uppercase. By the use of this toggle case, this option switches the case of the text. It switches the case of the text. That means upper characters. The upper characters, the capital letters will be changed into small letters and the lowercase characters, that means the small letters will be changed into capital letters. Okay, so the first one was sentence case, in which the first letters in a sentence will be changed into capital letters. Then lowercase, in this option all the case of the entire text will be changed into small letters. Okay, then comes the uppercase. This uppercase option changes the entire text into capital letters, that is uppercase. Okay, and then comes capitalize each word. This option capitalizes the first letter of each word in the sentence. Okay, then comes the toggle case. This option switches the case of the text. Okay, that means uppercase characters will be turned into small letters, that means lowercase, and the lowercase characters that will be changed into uppercase characters, that is in capital letters. Okay, so have you understood the changing case? Yes. Now I will show you how this changing case options will be changed. Okay, how can you change the uppercase to lowercase, how can you change the case of the text? Okay, so now students, how will you change the case of the text? These are the following steps that are mentioned there. Can you see? First is you select the text. Second, first of all you will select the text that you want to change. Okay, secondly you click on the home tab and then click on the change case button in the font group. First of all you will select your text that you want to change. After that click on home tab and then click on the change case button in the font group. Where will you find this change case button? You will find this change case button in the font group in the home tab. Okay, and then you can choose the desired option from the drop down list. Okay, you can choose the desired option from the drop down list. Okay, so these are the steps. How will you choose the change case option? First, you will select the text, then you will click on the home tab, and then click on the change case button in the front in the font group, and after that choose the desired option from the drop down list that you want to change your text in the document. Okay, so students, where will you find this change case option? You will find in this home tab. Okay, you will go in this home tab, in the font group you will click here in this option, change case. Can you see it is written there, change case? Can you see? Yes. And after that you will click here, you can see the options there, sentence case, lower case, upper case, capitalize each word, and toggle case. You can use these options to change the text in your document according to your requirement. Okay, if you want to change the text, you can change it from these options that you'll get in this font group. Okay, first you will go in the home tab, after that you in the font group, in the font group you can see this one, this option here. These are the options to change the case. Okay, now students, our next content is inserting symbols. Okay, you can also insert symbols in your document. Okay, in your MS Word document you can also insert symbols. Okay, the insert menu help us to insert various objects in MS Word document. Okay, this insert menu helps us to insert various objects in MS Word document. Various objects can also be inserted inside the MS Word document. Okay, this menu has 7 groups. This insert menu has how many groups? It has 7 groups. Okay, those are pages, tables, illustrations, links, header and footer, text and symbols. Okay, you can add number of pages if you want to. Okay, there are unlimited number of pages you can write your text in. Okay, you will find many pages for writing text or for making a document. Okay, then there are tables, you can insert tables in your document. Then there is illustration, you can illustrate any kind of text in your document. Okay, then there is links, any kind of links if you want to add, you can add in your documents. Headers and footers. Headers means the text that is written in the top of your document, that is headers. And what are footers? That is written below at the bottom of your document, that are headers and footers. Okay, you can also add headers and footers in your document. The text that are written at the top of the document are called as headers, and the text that are written at the bottom of the document or page that are known as footers. Okay, and then you can also add text and symbols. Any kind of text and symbols if you want to add, you can add in your document. Okay, after that, symbols are added frequently in mathematical equations. If you are doing some mathematical work, then you can use symbols, because these symbols are frequently used for mathematical equations. Okay, like equal sign, greater, smaller, greater than, smaller, smaller signs. Okay, then equal signs, these kind of symbols you can use in your mathematical equations. Okay, we can also add foreign letters and shapes such as hearts, diamonds and arrows. We can also use these kind of symbols in our document. Okay, there are also copyright symbols, trademark symbols and other symbols like marks and Unicode characters. Okay, that can be added in a document. Okay, that can be added in a document, that we need to add in a document, it can be added. Okay, and after that, these symbols are generally not found in the keyboard. These symbols are not generally found in the keyboard. Where it is found? It is found in this insert menu. These symbols, like the symbols of trademark, then other symbols like marks, Unicode characters, these are not found in the keyboard. Okay, and where it is found? It is found in the insert menu. Okay, these symbols are found in the insert menu, and you can add these symbols in your document or you can add it in your text. Okay, now let us move to the next step. So students, how will you insert a symbol? What are the steps to insert a symbol in your document? Okay, first of all, you place the cursor at a position where we want to insert a symbol. First of all, we will place our cursor to the position where we want to add a symbol. Okay, first bring your cursor to the position where you want to add a symbol. Okay, after that, you click on the insert tab. Secondly, you will click on the insert tab. Click on the symbol option present in the symbols group. First of all, you will bring your cursor to the position where you want to add the symbol. Okay, after that, you will click on the insert tab. Okay, then after that, you will click on the symbol option that you will find in the symbol group in the insert tab. Okay, to see more symbols, click on more symbols option. If you want to see more symbols, then you click on the more symbol option. Okay, after that, a symbol dialog box will appear. A symbol dialog box will appear on the screen. Okay, and after that, select the desired symbol and then you click on the insert button and click on close. After that, after a symbol dialog box will appear, you select your desired symbol and after that you click on the insert button and then you click on close. So these are the steps how will you insert a symbol in your document. Okay, I will repeat it again. First of all, you will place the cursor at the position where you want to insert the symbol. Secondly, you will click on the insert tab. Third, you will click on the symbol option present in the symbol group. To see more symbols, click on the more symbols option. Okay, after that, a symbol dialog box will appear on the screen and after that, select the desired symbol and then click on insert and then click on close. Okay, so these are the steps how will you insert a symbol in your document. Okay, now let me show you how will you open this. Okay, so students, how will you insert symbols in your document? Okay, first you will go in the insert tab. Can you see in the insert tab? Okay, first you click on the insert tab. There are different groups: pages, tables, illustrations, links, header and footer, text, symbols. Okay, these are the groups, okay, of insert tab. Okay, you will go in the symbols. Can you see here? You will go in this symbols. Okay, after that you will click here. If you want some equations, you can click on this equation and you can choose anything you want to, or you can click on symbols. Okay, these are the list of symbols that will appear. Can you see? Or you can click on more symbols more symbol groups will appear, and you can select any of the symbols you want to in your document and you can insert, and after that you close it. Okay, so this is the steps how will you insert symbols in your document. Okay, now students, moving to the next content, that is word count. Okay, MS Word automatically counts the number of word in the document. At the bottom left corner of the screen, the total number of pages and the total word count are displayed. It also shows the current page number. Now, what is word count? In MS Word, this MS Word automatically counts the number of words in the document. Okay? The words or the sentence that you have typed in your document, this MS Word automatically counts the number of the words that you have typed in your document. Okay? At the bottom left corner of the screen of your MS Word screen, of your MS Word window screen, you can see in the bottom left corner of the screen the total number of pages that you have worked on and the total word count are displayed. How many words you have used to type and how many pages, how many number of pages you have used. Okay, all that are displayed at the bottom left corner of the screen. You can find it there. Okay, then it also shows the current page number. The current page number that you are working on, it also shows. Okay, this word count is in MS Word, this MS Word counts the number of words, the number of pages, the current page number that you are working on, it counts automatically. That is word count in MS Word. Okay, so to find the word count of the document, we can follow the mentioned steps below. By following the mentioned steps below, we can find the word count of the document. Okay, the first is click on the review tab. Firstly, you will click on the review tab. Okay, then secondly, in the proofing group, click on the word count. Okay, first you will click on the review tab, and in the proofing group, you click on word count button. Okay, after that, a word count dialog box will appear. A word count dialog box will appear showing the details like number of pages, paragraph, line, and word in the documents. It also displays the number of characters with and without spaces. Okay, what is that dialog box? The word count dialog box that appears will show you the details of the number of words that you have used, then number of pages, paragraph, lines, words in the document. Okay, and it will also display the number or character with or without spaces. It will also display the number of characters that you have used with or without spaces. Okay? So students, where will you find this word count? You go in the review option. Okay? You go in the review option. After that, in the proofing group, can you see here? In the proofing group, you click on word count. Okay, this is word count. Okay, now you can select number of pages. The words that I have written, there are zero words I have used. That is why no count is mentioned there. And the pages, I am using this single page. That is why the number of pages, it has been displayed one. Okay, after that you can close this. Okay, you go in the review tab, after that you click on word count, and this is the word count box. This is the dialog box that will appear, showing all the details of pages, words, characters, with space or with no space, paragraph, lines, everything. It will be shown here. Okay? After that, you can close it. Okay? So, this is how you can find the word count of your document. Okay? So, students, I hope you have understood this chapter. Yes? So, let us do a quick revision on the topics that we have, sorry, on the contents that we have studied so far. Okay? First of all, we studied about the find and replace command, isn't it? To search specific word or text and replace it with another word or text in Word, the find and replace command are combined. Okay? To search specific word or text in our document and to replace it with another word, which command do we use? We use find and replace command, isn't it? With the help of this find and replace command, we can find any text or word in our document that we want to, and we can also, with the use of this replace command, we can replace any word or text in our document, isn't it? Then secondly, we learn about spelling and grammar errors. Yes, we can use spelling and grammar features to correct and check any spelling and grammatical mistake in our document. With the help of this spelling and grammar command, we can check and correct any spelling and grammar mistake in our document. Okay? A wavy blue line represent a grammatical mistake. A wavy blue line represent a grammatical mistake in our document. Okay? Whereas a wavy red line indicates a misspelled word. If a word is misspelled, if the spelling of a word is wrong, a red wavy line will indicate the mistake. Okay? In our document. Okay? Then we learned about thesaurus. Isn't it? A word can be replaced with any of its synonyms or antonyms by the use of this thesaurus feature. Okay, we can replace any word with any of its synonyms or antonyms by using this thesaurus feature in MS Word. Okay, and after that we studied about changing case. How can we change the case of a letter or word in our document, isn't it? The change case option are used to change the case of typed text in MS Word. With the use of this change case option, we can change the text. We can change the typed text in our MS Word document. Okay? And after that, how many kinds of cases are there? How many changing cases are there? There are 5 changing cases, isn't it? First one is sentence case. Second is lowercase. Yes. Then uppercase. Then capitalize each word. Then toggle case. In sentence case, the letters are changed into capital letters. The words are changed into capital letters. Then in lowercase, all the words or letters are changed into small letters. Okay? And after that, in uppercase, all the letters are changed into capital letters. Okay? And in capitalize each word, the first word of each stack of each text are changed into capital letters. Okay? And in toggle case, the first letter of the text is changed from uppercase to lowercase or from lowercase to uppercase. Okay? This is toggle case. Okay? And after that, we learned about symbols. Isn't it? Symbols can be inserted in Word document by using the symbol option. We can insert any kind of symbol in our Word document by using this symbol option. Okay, and after that, by using the word count features, we can count the total number of word, pages, characters with and without spaces, then paragraphs and lines in a document. So these were the content that we studied in this topic, more on MS Word. Okay, in the next class we will continue with the further topics. Okay students, I will give you some home assignment. You please practice this assignment at home. Okay, you please practice the assignment at home, and you please do the practicals, okay, in your computer at home. You please practice the practicals. Okay, so students, you please practice this assignment, this questions at home. Okay, the first question is, how does find and replace feature help us? Okay, how does this find and replace feature help us? I have already told you. Okay, to find any word or to replace a word, we can use the help of find and replace command. Okay, the next question is, what is the use of thesaurus in MS Word? Okay, you have understood what is thesaurus, isn't it? We can change a word with its synonyms or antonyms. We can use this thesaurus feature. Okay, and after that, what does word count feature tell us? I told you, what does this word count feature tell us? It tells us about the pages, the number of words, paragraph, lines, everything in a document, in a MS Word document. Okay, then explain the different options available to change the case of text in MS Word. Okay, the different options, the changing case options, I already told you what were the options. Those were sentence case, lower case, upper case, capitalize each word, and toggle case. Okay, you write this and you write their functions. Okay, and after that, write the steps to correct grammatical mistakes in a Word document. You write the steps, okay, to correct grammatical mistakes in Word document. I have already explained you. Yes, and the last question, what does a wavy red line indicates in Word document? What does this wavy red line indicates in Word document? Okay, so students, you please practice these questions at home, and you please also practice the practical. Okay, you try practicing the practical at home. Okay, so students, that's all for this topic. Okay, in the next class we will continue further with the next topic. Okay, so students, bye, take care of yourselves.